question right.
With Fritz, Dickerman, and Vito.
We got a tremendous, tremendous program tonight.
Oh, it's true. It's damn true.
You are now between the ropes.
Jason, speaking of the Hall of Fame, you know, I know there's been, you know, a lot of talk, speculation, some of which confirmed, some of which not, as far as who's going in this year. I know the Von Erichs, obviously, with the Texas. I've heard Von Erich family. I've heard different incarnations. Has there been any good word out there as far as is it going to be the family thing? Is it going to be like Kerry, David, Mike? What's going to be the content there, if at all?
Good question. I don't have an answer for you. I think we're all kind of just speculating on what they're going to do with the Hall of Fame. That being in Texas, I mean, there's so many different options.
Sure.
But, I mean, I just say put the whole family in. I mean, they're a part of wrestling history, and you can split hairs and say that, you know, Mike Von Erich doesn't belong. But, you know, if you just put the whole family in, I don't think too many people are going to complain.
I can accept Mike because before the whole, you know, toxic shock thing he had and all that in his brain cooked, he was serviceable. If they put Chris in, we have to boycott. We cannot allow Chris Von Erich to be in the Hall of Fame for anything.
Fair enough.
Now, who are some of the other names that are being bantied around? Because Bill Watts has gone out on the internet and says, I'm going in, so that could cost him. I don't know.
Oops.
And then and then I think you hear more and more talk about Terry and Dory Funk Jr. going in together as the Funk brothers rather than separately.
I don't think they even really like each other.
What's the scuttlebutt you've heard about them going in and then possibly some others?
Yeah, I think if you're going to have one Funk, you have to have both of them. I know most people would want to see them go separately, but if nothing else, just for time reasons, I think they go in together.
Just don't let Dory Funk talk. I mean, let Terry talk. It'll be so damn entertaining, man.
Dory,
oh, absolutely.
Son of a bitch, shut up. You're putting them all to sleep, damn it.
And I know where you guys are broadcasting from, so I definitely want to hear him say, and those Florida crackers.
He goes, Dusty Rhodes, you like second dog?
He'll do it.
Yeah,
he'll do it.
He'll go up. But I mean, it's funny because there's so many different guys that have come out of Texas, and it seems like everybody's going in. It's going to have a Texas tie-in. Let's get to the phones. Let's speak with Jim in Virginia. Let's talk about SmackDown. How's everything going, Jim?
Hey, guys, what's going on?
Jimbo.
Hey, Vito, what's going on, my man?
What's up, brother?
Brother, I tell you, we got to talk about this Victoria deal.
I'm sad.
I am, too. You know,
me and
you have went to the bat for her.
Yeah.
We've always stuck up for her.
Yes, we have.
I'm going to tell you this. I wish she would have just freaked out last Tuesday when they taped it and beat the crap out of Michelle.
It would have been fun. I'd enjoyed it, and she sure the hell could have.
I mean, but she's so loyal to them.
She is. And, and you'll not hear her say a bad word about them in the aftermath. It won't happen. It won't happen.
And they couldn't give her 3 minutes to show her farewell to the fans on SmackDown on TV. They could not show that. You had to go online to see that.
Yeah. Well,
I mean, I thought, and I don't think she retired. I think she got tired of that crap, and she quit or left, whatever you want to call it, because they were jobbing her out. I mean, how many times did she have to put the Bella Twins over?
I don't know.
I mean, it's just, and she will go to TNA. I have heard through the grapevine, like you, a whole lot of things about she will go to TNA, and I think she will be a big hit there, too.
I don't think she, you know, again, I wouldn't want to say for sure she's going to TNA. You never know, but she's got options for sure. I can tell you I don't believe for half a second that she's done. Now, do I think that we've necessarily seen the last of her in the WWE? No. I could absolutely foresee her making her way back there in the future at some point.
The thing that I found interesting is that she did this retirement speech, but they didn't air it on TV. It was online.
That's what Jim was saying.
Yeah, you know, but they didn't go that far. So, you know, who knows where she's going to pop up. You know what the thing is, though? If she shows up in TNA, she's going to have to be a babyface. And I've always thought that her best character is always
better
heel.
Much better heel.
When
yes,
she was
she
that
is.
Vicious heel going around yes. and just kiboshing
well,
people.
Well, because she fits the role. She's big. She's athletic. Yeah. She's strong. She's powerful. And she's, I mean, let's be dead honest. I mean, I think, if I'm not, what is she, 5'9"? 5'8", 5'9".
Sounds about
right. She's pretty tall. I mean, I know when first time I ever met her, I was like, okay, you know, she's a pretty tall girl. She fits that role, and she can be such a dominant. That's why, I mean, honestly, hey, the Bella Twins are gorgeous and all, don't get me wrong, but what is she doing putting them over? Come on. Come on. That's a joke. That's a joke. Anybody with half a brain knows if they got together and hooked up and had at it, she would beat those two like rented donkeys. Wouldn't he be funny?
Speak with Greg in Mexico City. Greg, thanks for joining us on the show.
Guys, how's it going?
Good,
Greg.
Man.
Hey, what's going on, Vito? Hey, I got to say, Vito and I have been having some decent political discussion on the MySpace blog.
Yeah, what is that steroids rule crap? What is that?
I didn't say that. That was my brother.
What was that? Your evil twin?
Evil twin. Yeah, that's him.
That's him. They cloned me in Mexico. Yeah.
Yeah, call me in Mexico, but he wears a sombrero. Yeah, that's it.
Nice.
Anyways, just wanted to say real quick, that was an awesome kick in the head that Vince McMahon took. It looked straight up legit, if you ask me.
I think it was. I really do.
When you see that head, just starts to shift. That was kind of reminding me of like when you watch the playoffs on Sunday when Willis McGahee got crushed and you see his head just hit the ground. Kind of reminded me just like that.
Willis's neck, by the way, is still in significant pain. While we're on the topic, this is a good example here, because now Ring of Honor, and you're working with Ring of Honor, you're definitely, you know, you're in a featured role, you're doing, you know, great up there. Ring of Honor is a company that kind of had a reputation, at least early on, and I think it's kind of subsided, but it was known for just being, you know, spot, daredevil, flip-flop, fly, you know, and that was kind of the rep, and it was like this, you know, this young man's company, and, you know, there was times that guys would, you know, they're coming from the Fed, and they were coming, they'd work a spot there. And they were booed by the Ring of Honor crowd because it's like, oh, you work for the Fed, you're a sellout, you're this, you're that. Now, I think that has kind of softened over time, for sure. But what's your feel? What's the vibe so far being a regular part of Ring of Honor and definitely being the most veteran member of that crew? What's your feel on that kind of vibe now with the youthfulness of the company? How's your reception there?
It's been great. I have no complaints. And the guys, you know, they just welcomed me in, and they've, a lot of them are asking advice and want to learn. And like you said, early on, you know, Ring of Honor was just a big spot fest. And I guess they educated the fans and raised the bar so that the fans expect so much. And it just got ridiculous, you know. It was like, pretty soon you're going to have to wrap a cement truck in barbed wire and run out someone over to be able to pin them.
No, that's,
or they would have kicked out at one.
That's CZW.
Yeah, there you go.
Now, let me ask you this, because I know some people have done this to continue their career, and that's something that we even saw a little bit of an aspect of in the movie. Is that something you'd ever go to, is doing hardcore-style matches?
Well, you've seen, you know, some of the stuff. I mean, I've done a lot of hardcore matches.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't get crazy and do the glass tubes or panes of glass or barbed wire or running around barefoot in 10,000 thumbtacks or anything.
So we're not going to expect a Jerry Lynn Necro Butcher feud anytime real soon?
No, you will see me scream like a woman and run.
Thank God. I'd come over there and slap you upside the head if you tried to do matches like that.
And that, Jerry, is why we love you.
I'm not above turning around and running. I'll tell you that.
Trust me, Jerry's a wuss.
I see someone with a staple gun coming at me, I'm backpedaling in a heartbeat.
Being around Jerry as much as I've been, I know that he's a wuss, plain and simple. So
I'm allergic to pain.
Exactly.
I'm laughing because I was in a hardcore battle royal about 5 years ago, and I saw Haystacks Calhoun Jr. come running at me with a full-size cactus with intent. And I ran and leaped over the rope and flew. Oh, hell no.
Nice.
Oh, hell no.
So
I would have ran all the way into the back, grabbed my envelope from the promoter, and grabbed my bags and kept on running.
I didn't stop. They didn't see me leave that building.
Nice.